Sturdy Elliot, retired social worker with the Ministry of Children and Family Development. Am I correct?
Yeah, that's me. Who are you?
I'm Detective Taylor. We'd just like to ask you a few questions about the case of Ella Jackson. We've been notified that she was the last case of your career.
Yes, that's correct also.
Did what happened to her foster family have anything to do with your early retirement?
That was one of the factors, yes.
Miss Elliot, we'd like you to tell us the full story of Ella Jackson.
Why?
We'll tell you after you tell us.
Why can't you check the records? I'm sure
your Division of Child Welfare wiped most of the girl's records after her breakdown. Ella Jackson doesn't exist anymore.
It was around Christmas of 2011. I'll be with you until we find you a new home. But we'll start looking when you get better.
In my new home? Will the mirror man follow me there?
Who's the mirror man?
I first saw him the night Mum died. He was standing behind Dad, whispering something. When Mum said that everything was going to be okay, he was there. I saw him in the bathroom mirror. He just stood there, trying to tell me something.
Can you hear him?
Yes.
When was the last time he spoke to you?
He's talking to me right now.
I asked what he was saying, but she didn't answer. That was the only information that I got about the mirror man. Every time that she would look at her reflection, he would be behind her.
From her description, he bore a resemblance to her father. Did she ever mention anything of this nature to you?
Do you think we can move on?
Okay. What was her first response to the foster family?
She really liked them. We searched for 3 years and found her a new family. The O'Callaghans.
So we've put small blinds over each mirror in the house, and we're more than happy to set up an extra bed in my daughter's room.
Ella and I really thought it was the right decision. We were both wrong. I stopped seeing her after she was adopted by the O'Callaghans. The last thing I heard that concerned Ella was her death.
I'll be right back. It's your right to know. We have Ella's old diary in evidence. You might like to read it.
Dear diary, I think it was a mistake for Miss Elliot to leave me here. Mrs. O'Callaghan's okay, but her kids are horrible. James is constantly teasing me about the mirror man. I should never have told him what he looks like. Harriet is no better. All she talks about is having to cover her mirror with ugly curtains after I moved in. When she leaves them open, I can feel him getting closer. I can't keep him out. I'll write more soon. I just need to try and figure myself out.
Love, Ella.
Keep reading.
It's been a week since Mr. O'Callaghan decided I was well enough to remove the curtains from the mirrors. I've tried covering them back up, but every time I get close enough, he's there, waiting for me. I'm beginning to hear him again. He wouldn't stop whispering to me. He just wouldn't stop. I wanted him to stop. I told him to stop, but he wouldn't. I did something bad. I had to. He insisted. No one knows except the mirror man and me. I wonder if he'll tell anyone. I know I won't.
Love, Ella. Why did you not tell me any of this happened?
After the purge of Alan's files, we didn't know how much you knew. Please, keep reading.
Dear diary, I hate them all.
Yesterday, when Mrs. O'Callaghan was out, I went to the storage closet to look for something. I was inside when Harriet and James closed the door after attaching a mirror to the other side. He was standing right behind me for half an hour. I was locked in there, screaming, for half an hour. When Mrs. O'Callaghan came back, she got angry at me. She hit me. She told me to stop being childish and thinking there's a man in the mirror. He keeps on talking to me. Even when I'm not near any reflection, I can hear him. Can't keep my mind off him. He's always itching at the back of my head.
I think I'm lying to myself when I say I'm in control.
Don't look. He's coming. I can't keep him out. Don't look. He's coming. I can't keep him out. 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 Why won't they move the mirror? I'm in the hospital, and I think I hurt James. I just can't remember. There's a mirror in my hospital room. I've asked them to move the mirror, but they just won't. Why won't they move the mirror? He isn't coming for me. He's just laughing. I've let him in, and he isn't doing anything. He's just laughing.
I hope you'll tell me what's going on soon. This isn't ink, is it?
This entry was lost.
He's here. He's here and he's never leaving. He won't leave. He can't leave. Please don't leave. It's just him and me. Just me and him. He's always been there. The only one that's ever been there. He isn't leaving.
I won't let him.
That entry was written in the blood of the O'Callaghan family. Harriet and James's bodies were found 2 days later, both with shards of the broken family mirror down their throats. Ella had burnt alive after setting her old family home alive. Due to excessive burns, DNA testing was halted. Catherine O'Callaghan survived, but she soon developed Alzheimer's and was moved to a nursing home. That brings us to why you're here. We've recently reopened the case of Ella Jackson.
What? Why?
2 days ago, Catherine O'Callaghan was found dead. After an autopsy, police presumed that she suffered from a heart attack. However, that still doesn't explain why her mirror was stolen and why they found shards of glass down her throat.